Welcome back to another edition of Georgia Forages, the digital series. My name is Lisa Baxter, and I'm your University of Georgia State Forage Extension Specialist. I have received several calls over the past couple of weeks about Bermudagrass that is stunted, browning, or just struggling to green up this spring. Most of these calls have been about Alicia Bermudagrass, found throughout the southern parts of our state. But the things we're going to talk about in this video can affect any Bermudagrass variety and be found throughout any region of our state. There are several things that could be happening right now in your Bermudagrass, but let's look at the top three that I've seen over the past couple of weeks. Let's start with cold injury, such as frost damage or cold weather. We usually see this in late winter or early spring. The leaves almost look burned because of this damage. Any leaf is susceptible, but we see it more often in new young growth. All of our varieties can have cold damage, but some are certainly more tolerant than others. Next, let's identify leaf spot. Now, leaf spot is a generic term. We usually have to differentiate them microscopically, but we usually see this in late fall because of the more conducive conditions. However, this spring, we're seeing a lot of leaf blight. That's dark brown or black, usually has irregular lesions, and the damage is closer to the leaf collar. We're also seeing a lot of leaf rust that's usually red or orange, has small circular lesions, often throughout the leaves and even the stems of the Bermudagrass. Now, any leaf is susceptible. We usually first see this in older growth because of the mobility of potassium throughout the plant. Alicia and Common are certainly the most susceptible varieties to leaf spot, but it's possible that any variety could be damaged given low potassium levels. Finally, let's identify Bermudagrass stem maggot damage. We usually see the stem maggot damage show up in May to June, depending on weather and latitude. The damage is only seen in the top 2 to 3 leaves of each grass tiller. Sure, these leaves will easily pull out of the stem, differentiating them from any leaf spot. Our fine stem varieties are more susceptible, such as Alicia or Coastal, whereas our thicker stem varieties, like Coast Cross 2 or Tifton 85, are much more tolerant to this damage. So now you may be asking, what are my management options from here? Well, if we had cold injury, our only option is to let it grow and plan ahead for future seasons. We need to reduce plant stress by controlling insects and weeds, but also fertilizing and liming. In particular, don't forget about the potash. Potash is critical to cold tolerance and winter survival of Bermudagrass. When it comes to leaf spot, we need to harvest now and fertilize yesterday. Harvesting really is our only option because there are no effective, legal, or economical chemical options available to treat leaf spot. Prevention really is the key to managing leaf spot in our Bermudagrass. First, we need to choose a less susceptible variety, such as Tifton 85 or Russell. Second, manage your irrigation because diseases thrive in wet and warm environments. Third, minimize the thatch layer because it can tie up nutrients and creates a good environment to foster diseases. Fourth, harvest on time. This reduces the older leaf tissues that are more prone to spot because of the potassium mobility throughout the plant. Finally, let's talk about the BSM. We want to scout first and spray later. We always need to scout before starting a treatment plan. We want to see at least 20 flies per 20 swings of the net, but the stage of your grass growth can also affect your plan. We are within 7 to 10 days of harvest. We want to harvest as normal before we start applying insecticides. Now, if we have severe stunning in less than 6 inches of growth, we need to remove that damaged material and then start our treatment plan. However, if we've harvested within the last 10 days and we've met the threshold of flies in our sweet net, we need to start our treatment plan now. Our management plan includes 2 applications of a pyrethroid insecticide labeled for Bermudagrass. We need to apply the first application 7 to 10 days after harvest, and the second one 7 to 10 days after the first application. Apply the insecticide as low as possible with a high volume of water to make sure that the insecticide penetrates into the canopy where the flies have a higher population. We've also seen that the flies are more active early in the morning, so your insecticide will be more effective if sprayed before 9 a.m. So you're probably wondering, why is all of this happening now? Well, the situation is rare, but it can happen. We had drought-stressed Bermudagrass going into winter with low soil and plant potassium. We've had hot and cold periods throughout the winter and spring that led to erratic green up. And when we couple that with the severe weather over the past couple of weeks, we've really created an environment conducive to pathogens and insect pests. Overall, our weather has been warmer this spring, which means the Bermudagrass stem maggot shows up a little earlier than normal because it moves with the weather. And so as you can see, we really have created the perfect storm so that you may be seeing 1, 2, or even all 3 of these damage issues in your Bermudagrass pasture or hayfield right now. If you have any questions about identifying or managing these problems in Bermudagrass, contact your local extension agent. We also have resources available at www.georgiaforages.com.